come.
Tunamshukuru Mungu kwa kupatia hii nafasi ya kuweza kusimama na to be able to stand in the gap in the nations of the earth and to continue to declare the word of the Lord. Straight to the chest. The word of the Lord says in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 23, I received from the Lord what I also gave unto you the night the Lord Jesus Christ was betrayed. He took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, this is my body which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after the supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he said, this cup is a new covenant in my blood. Do this every time you drink it in remembrance of me. For whenever you eat of this bread and drink of this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Maskani zako zapendeza kama nini, e Bwana wa majeshi. How pleasant are your courts, my dear Father. Tunaomba tukianza, we pray as we start and commit this bread before the Lord and commit this cup before the Lord, even as we commence in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Father, we bless your name. We give you praise. We give you adoration in the name of Jesus. Nakabidhi mkate mbele wako, and I pray that, Lord, even as I partake of this bread and drink of this cup, that your name will be upon us. Father, we pray. We pray, thanking you for giving us another time to call on your name and to document these scriptures. Na kuomba haya madhabahu, katika haya madhabahu, kukabidhi haya maombi mbele zako. We pray that God will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. So we thank you and we bless you. In Jesus' mighty name, we continue to pray. Amen, 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 amen. Join me.
Oh, Elohim,
Even faints for the courts of the Lord. My heart and my flesh cry out for the living God. Nafsi yangu imezionea shauku nyua za Bwana. Naam, na kuzikondea. Moyo wangu na mwili wangu vinamlilia Mungu aliye hai. Reba sundara bazikara basete. Reka bashoroko zayata. Yimbazara kazotoro zaya kantere zaya busi tiriata. Oh my Lord, there is none like you. Hakuna kama wewe. There is none. Welcome somebody. Welcome. Welcome, Brother Zach. What you say, yes, you will. There is no other God like you. Even the sparrow, verse 3. Chomoro nae ameuona nyumba. Na mbayuwayu amejipatia kioto. Alipoweka makinda yake. Kwenye dhahabu madhabahu yako, Bwana wa majeshi. Mungu, mfalme wangu na Mungu wangu. Even the sparrow has found a home. The swallow a nest for herself, where she may have a young, a place near your altar. Lord Almighty, my King and my God. For blessed are those who dwell in your house. Heri wakao nyumbani mwako. wanakuhimidi daima. Verse 5. Heri wakaao nyumbani mwako. Wanakuhimidi daima. Heri ambaye nguvu zake zatoka kwako. Na njia ziendazo Sayuni zimo mioyoni mwake. 6. As they pass through the valley of Baca, they make it a place of springs. The autumn rains also cover it with pools. Wakipita katika bonde la vilio, ulifanya kuwa chemichemi. Maam, mvua ya vuli ulivika baraka. They make it a place of springs. The autumn rains also cover it with pools. 7. They go from strength to strength till each appears before God in Zion. Wendelea toka nguvu hata nguvu. Uonekana Sayuni kila mmoja mbele za Mungu. 8. Hear my prayer, Lord God Almighty. Listen to me, God of Jacob. Bwana Mungu wa majeshi, ujasikiae maombi yangu. E Mungu wa Yakobo, usikilize. This one in Swahili is so profound. It says, you God who hears prayer. You God who hears prayer. Listen to my prayers. Listen to my prayers. You who hears prayer. Listen to my prayers. As the prayer that we are making from Psalm 84, verse number 8. Psalms 84, verse number 8. Jehovah, Dios de los Etiquitos, oye mi oración. Esuka, o Dios de Jacob, Selah. In the Spanish tongue, it says, in Swahili, Bwana, Mungu wa majeshi, usikiae maombi yangu. E Mungu wa Yakobo, usikilize. Hear my prayer, Lord God Almighty. Listen to me, God of Jacob. Verse 9. E Mungu ngao yetu, uangalie, mtazame uso masihi wako. Look on our shield, O God. Look with favor on your anointed one. 10. Hakika siku moja katika nyua yako ni bora kuliko siku elfu. Ningependa kuwa bawabu nyumbani mwa Mungu wangu kuliko kukaa katika hema ya uovu. For the he said, better is one day in your courts than a thousand elsewhere. I would rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God than dwell in the tents of the wicked. Verse 11. For the Lord God is a sun and shield. The Lord bestows favor and honor. No good thing does he withhold from those whose work is blameless. Lord Almighty, blessed is the one who trusts in you. Verse number 11 to 12. I want you to pray for yourself now. Those of you in Los Angeles right now, those of you that are in Miami, you are already moving into the fourth watch of the night. We are in a place of prayer. We are in the place of calling on the name of the Lord, a place of seeking the face of the Lord. In Honolulu, as they are ascending up, they are the last born of the day. They are still in Thursday. When you think it is late, they are still on Thursday in Honolulu. When you think it is too early, in Auckland, in New Zealand, right now, they are entering into their night watch at 9 on Friday. Beloved, in Dublin, they are waking up at 7. We thank God that the time zones that we are all in tell us one thing. The people in Santiago, they are already at 4 in the morning. Dallas, Missouri, all these people, wote hawa watu wanaishi hiyo pande ni saa 8 dakika 44. Ni kumaanisha nini na hii time naongea? Ya kwamba Mungu ni Mungu wa majira. God is a God of time, a God of season, a God of the moment. A divine shield, ngao ya kimungu, ni jambo ambalo tunahitaji. We need right now the shield of God. Mankind has come up with a shield for his nose. shield for his mouth. Amekuja na kitu inaitwa barakoa. Hayo mambo ambayo amepata ya kufunika mdomo wake. Let me show you so that you can understand something. You see, this year, is a shield. This is a shield. Now this shield, a couple of months ago, if you put on this shield, people would have wondered, what are you hiding? Are you a doctor or are you a robber? But now we have come to a time when we must remember to shield our nose and mouth. These two areas are the source. Hizi sehemu mbili ndio sehemu ambazo zinakupeleka rohoni ama zinakutenga na rohoni. Unachoongea, what you speak, kama hakuna ngao ya kimungu, utaongea mambo ambayo yatakuharibia msingi wako ndani ya Mungu. Ndio nasema ya kuwa Mungu ni jua na ngao. Bwana atatoa neema na utukufu. Hata wanyima kitu chema hao waendao kwa uaminifu. Hata wanyima. Ili jambo ambalo Mungu amesema. Kuna mahali ingine amesema atashibisha nafsi ya wanao tenda mema. That God will satisfy you with long life. The divine shield of God need to come to a place where you take yourself seriously when it comes to the things of God. Unaweka mchezo kando na kumwambia Mungu sasa, mimi nimeamua kuwa serious. I've decided to be serious with you. As well, you are there wondering, what time is it? In Melbourne, they are already at 6 p.m. waiting for the night to appear. They are already at 6 p.m. there. Sydney kule, wago wamefika. Seoul Korea kwa kina Celestine, ni saa 10 na dakika 47. Yani wako tayari kwenda, siku imeenda mbio. But the divine shield of God is the one that can keep us safe in these times of the pandemic. Whether you are working from home, or whether you are working in the location, one thing remains, that we need a divine shield. A shield from the Lord. For the Lord is a sun and a shield. And no good thing will he withhold from them whose work is blameless. Mungu anasema haya mambo. Ya kwamba Mungu ni jua na ngao. Morana naelewa ngao. The army understand a shield. When they go out fighting the enemy. And the enemy decides to use human beings as shields. They know akishika mtoto, jeshi atapiga risasi yake. They know that when they hold a baby in front of the army cannot kill that baby. They put a human shield. But the shield I'm talking about is a divine shield. That God is going to release a divine shield. That's why Psalm 91 it says, for he who dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. Surely he will save you from the fowler's snare and from the deadly pestilence. We need to move on to the book of Proverbs because I need us to pray at the end of this broadcast. We need to move quickly and we need to pray. Psalms, we are done with Psalm 84. We go to Proverbs. Methali 21. Proverbs 21. In the Lord's hand, the king's heart is a stream. That's you gonna sound the trumpet. In the Lord's hand, the king's heart is a stream of water that he channels towards all who please him. A person may think their own ways are right, but the Lord weighs the heart. The plans to do what is right is just and just is more acceptable to the Lord than sacrifice. Tuko kwa methali. Verse 4. Haughty eyes and a proud heart, the unplowed field of the wicked, produce sin. Macho yenye kiburi na moyo wa kutabakari, hata ukulima wa uovu ni dhambi. The plans of the diligent lead to profit, as surely as haste leads to poverty. Mawazo ya mwenye bidii huelekea utajiri tu, bali kila mwenye pupa huelekea uhitaji. Hallelujah. Verse number 6. A fortune made by a lying tongue is a fleeting vapor and a deadly snare. Kupata akiba ya mali kwa ulimi ya uongo, wa uongo ni moshi upeperushwao ni kutafuta mauti. The violence of the wicked will drag them away, for they refuse to do what is right. Welcome dada yetu Lea Gedenji. Na pia dada yetu Charity Medhamo from Brussels. God bless you so much at this early morning that you are tuning in to this broadcast. Verse 8. Njia yake aliyelemewa na dhambi imepotoka sana, bali mtu aliye safi kazi yake ni sawa sawa. The way of the guilty is devious, but the conduct of the innocent is upright. 9. Ni afadhali kukaa katika pembe ya darini kuliko katika nyumba pana pamoja na mwanamke mgomvi. Mm-hmm. My sisters, this one is for you. Listen. Better to live in a corner of a roof than share a house with a quarrelsome wife. 10. The wicked crave evil. Their neighbors get no mercy from them. 11. When a mocker is punished with simple gain, the simple gain wisdom, by paying attention to the wise, they get knowledge. Nafsi ya mtu mbaya utamani uovu. Jirani yake apati kufadhili machoni pake. Mwenye mzaha aadhibuapo, mjinga upata hekima. Na mwenye hekima afundishwapo upokea maarifa. The righteous one takes note of the house of the wicked and brings the wicked to ruin. Whoever shuts their ears to the cry of the poor will also cry out and not be answered. Mwenye haki utafakari nyumba ya mtu mbaya. Jinsi wabaya waangushwavyo wakaangamia. Azibae masikio yake, asisikie kilio cha maskini. Yeye naye atalia, lakini hata sikiwa. 14. A gift given in secret soothes anger, and a bribe concealed in the cloak pacifies great wrath. Kipawa cha siri utuliza hasira, na rushwa bindoni humliza ghadhabu kali. When justice is done, it brings joy to the righteous, but terror to evildoers. When justice is done, it brings joy to the righteous. Mithali 21:15. Ni furaha yao wenye haki kutenda hukumu, lakini ni uharibifu wao watendao maovu. 16. Mtu aikosaye njia ya busara atakaa katika mkutano wao waliokufa. Whoever strays from the path of prudence comes to rest in the company of the dead. Mtu apendaye anasa atakuwa maskini, apendaye mvinyo na mafuta hatakuwa tajiri. Whoever loves pleasure will become poor. Whoever loves wine and olive oil will never be rich. 18. Mtu asiye haki ni fidia na wenye haki, naye afanyaye hila ni badala ya watu wa adili. Verse 18. The wicked become a ransom for the righteous, and the unfaithful for the upright. 19. Ni afadhali kukaa katika nchi ya nyika kuliko na mwanamke mgomvi mchokozi. Eh? Unasikia hiyo maneno? The wicked become a ransom for the righteous, and the upright for the upright, and they are unfaithful for the upright. Then verse 19, it repeats again the issue about the wife. It says, better to live in a desert than with a quarrelsome and nagging wife. Bibi mchokozi. Hakiswahili. Inasema, bibi mchokozi. The nagging wife. What is nagging? Nagging is somebody may come and ask you a question that you answered yesterday. And the Bible likens a nagging wife, mke mchokozi, ambaye anauliza swali, is asking a question, knowing the answer, but the question is being targeted at you so that you may be able to feel something apart from just being asked a question. The Bible says, it's better to live in a desert than with a quarrelsome and nagging wife. Kuliko na mwanamke mgomvi, mchokozi. A word is enough for the wise. The wise store up choice food and olive oil, but fools gulp theirs down. My brother, ugo chuku, umoneaku. I need to play something from Nigeria for you. Eh? Something just to welcome you. You know when barista is around, everything is okay. I bless the Lord. Let me play for you something from Nigeria just because you have come out of your busy schedule to just come and listen to these words from the Lord. Yeah? My brother Nathaniel Bassi should come with a wonderful number and just tell us something. Olo wo gwoboro. The one with an outstretched arm. Nathaniel Bassi, the man of God. I can't wait to come to Nigeria and just meet this wonderful man of God that the Lord has connected us with in this journey. We've listened to a lot of Nathaniel Bassi. a lot of Nathaniel Bassey, a lot. And he blesses us. We thank God for the Hallelujah Project, what you are doing the other time in this time. Olowogboro. Did I get the spelling correct? I think I did. So for my brother Ugo Chuku Umoneaku, barrister, and also another barrister in Kenya, my sister Viola, I celebrate you, counsel, and may the Lord bless you. We're taking this slight break. Jocelyn Ness Anna Mwangi, that found it in your time to tune in live.
You are stretched out, giving us victory. Miracles, signs, and wonders come from you. Just like that, oh,
testimonies just like that.
Was an honor enough to tell of what you've done.
Oh my God. Okay, let's get back to Proverbs, because the Lord is turning things back for His God in the name of Jesus. Proverbs 21, I'm reading in English and Swahili, if you're just joining me. Very soon, my brother, we are going to be reading in Igbo. Igbo language. You will see right here on this channel. We will see speaking in Igbo language, in Yoruba language, in those other many languages, because God has called us to the nations. And the nations are not countries. They are languages. They are tribes. They are people. And God says in the Revelation chapter 10 verse 14. It's something that you need to understand. And I'm going to read it to you in the language of this nation. It says, Wakaniambia, imekupasa kutoa unabii tena juu ya watu na taifa na lugha na wafalme wengi. Says that in the book of Revelation 10 verse 14. It says that God has calls you to speak, you know, to speak over the nations, to speak over the tribes, to speak over the kings of the nations. So to be multilingual is a blessing, because you are able to speak to nations of different type in the name of Jesus. Proverbs 21, verse 21. Whoever pursues righteousness and love finds love, prosperity, and honor. Whoever pursues righteousness and love finds life, prosperity, and honor. Whoever pursues righteousness finds life, prosperity, and honor. Andamanaye haki na fadhili ataona uhai na haki na heshima. Andamaye haki na fadhili ataona uhai na haki na heshima. Let me mention something here. What you are following has a reward. Whatever you pursue has a reward. Whoever pursues righteousness, that's why the word of the Lord says, seek first the kingdom of God and all its righteousness. That when you get your eyes to open and to understand that God calls you to do this thing, that whoever pursues righteousness and love finds life, prosperity, and honor. That when you are following righteousness, you're pursuing righteousness, which now righteousness has been given to us as a gift. Righteousness has been given to you as a gift. For Romans chapter 5, verse number 17, it says, if through one man death reigned through that one man, how much more will those they receive the gift of eternal life and the gift of righteousness reign in life through that one man Jesus Christ. Warumi 15 mstari wa 17. Kwa maana ikiwa kwa kukosa mtu mmoja mauti ilitawala kwa sababu ya yule mmoja, zaidi sana wao wapokeao wingi wa neema na kila kipawa cha haki. Kila kipawa, the gift of righteousness. Inasema kila kipawa cha haki watatawala katika uzima wa yule mmoja Yesu Kristo. That you shall reign in life through that one man, Jesus Christ. That's why it says, whoever pursues righteousness, anaye fata. Inasema namna gani? 21. Mwenye hekima. Iko wapi? 21. Methali 21. Mstari wa 21. Aandamaye haki na fadhili ataona uhai na haki na heshima. Whoever pursues righteousness and love finds life, prosperity and honor. Now focus your mind and say, see yourself in the highway. Then in front of you there is a truck and it's written righteousness and love. So when you see this truck, you tell yourself, I'm not leaving this truck out of my sight. Righteousness and love. Sitawacha kuandama. Haki. Sitawacha kuandama. Sitawacha kuandama. Fadhili. Haki na fadhili. Hizi vitu mbili, whoever pursues righteousness and love, whoever pursues righteousness and love, aandamae haki na fadhili, ataona uhai na haki na heshima. One who is wise can go up against the city of the mighty and pull down the stronghold which they trust. Kwenye wale mna deal na my altars, if you are dealing with altars and covenants and things that happened to you before, things that are in your family line or your generation, I want to give you this tip. Nataka kupatia wazo hili. That one who is wise, my brother Prabhu, welcome from India. We welcome you, my boss. He says, whoever pursues righteousness and love finds life, prosperity, and honor. In Swahili, it says, aandamaye haki na fadhili, ataona uhai na haki na heshima. Then the following verse says, one who is wise can go up against the city of the mighty and pull down the stronghold in which they trust. So this is something that we need to understand. It's not just a physical thing. It's spirit. Spirit. A lot of things you see and happening in the world today is spirit. You see, there's a Russian vaccine, there is an American vaccine, there is a Chinese vaccine, there is a vaccine for a vaccine and a vaccine. If you want to know, find out about your mask. Find out where is it coming from. If you try to put on a mask, takuvaa barakoa, ufunike hivi. Ujiulize, hii barakoa yangu imetengenezwa kutoka wapi? You trust the mask, but you don't know who made it. But you are just told that if you wear the mask, if you put this on, you are being protected from something you don't know. If you are putting the mask on, you cannot see it. But I found this tool very useful to remain quiet and silent for a long time. Where in the actual sense, I would be yapping. This is a tool made by men, a divine shield against particles. But there is another shield that you cannot see, And let me tell you something. The one who is wise can go up against the city of the mighty and pull down the stronghold in which they trust. This is something that you need to understand, that wisdom is there for those that desire wisdom. Again, in Proverbs 11:30, it says that the one who wins souls is wise. To win souls, you don't need to be an evangelist. You just need to be an obedient Christian. If you are an obedient Christian, then you will not leave anybody without asking them the question, would you like me to lead you to Jesus? Would you like me to lead you to Jesus? And most of the time they ask you, wow, they are not expecting. But you ask them that question. So those, listen to verse 23. Those who guard their mouths and their tongues keep themselves away from calamity. The pandemic of the earth is not about the virus. It is about your words. The greatest pandemic we have today is your words. There are people that when the world locked down last year, they have never unlocked. They are still crying. They are still saying, you know, they closed down everything for us. We used to be in this industry. Now it is closed. Oh, please help us. Your mouth. That mouth of yours. That mouth is a problem. Mtu azuiae kinywa chake na ulimi wake, atajilinda nafsi yake na tabu. Dadangu Susan, karibu sana. The proud and arrogant person, mocker is his name. He behaves in insolent fury. Mwenye kiburi na kutakabari, jina lake ni mbishi. Utenda mambo katika majivuno na kiburi chake. The craving of a sluggard will be the death of him because his hands refuse to work. Matakwa yake mtu mvivu umfisha, kwa maana mikono yake ukataa kufanya kazi. All day long he craves for more, but the righteous give without sparing. Verse 26. Kuna atamanie kwa choyo mchana kutwa, bali mwenye haki hutoa wala hanyimi. Verse 27. The sacrifice of the wicked is detestable. How much more so when brought with evil intent? Sadaka ya wasio haki ni chukizo. Si zaidi sana ailetapo mwenye nia mbaya. Verse 28. A false witness will perish, but a careful listener will testify successfully. Shahidi wa uongo atapotea, bali mtu asikiae atasema maneno ya dumuyo. Verse 29. The wicked put up a bold front, but the upright give thought to their ways. Asiye haki hufanya uso wake kuwa mgumu, bali mtu mnyofu huzifikiri njia zake. Verse 30. There is no wisdom. Tell them there is no wisdom. Tell them there is no wisdom. No insight. No plan that can succeed against the Lord. Verse 31. The horse is made ready for the day of battle, but the victory rests with the Lord. Hapana hekima wala fahamu. Wala shauri juu ya Bwana. Farasi wekwa tayari kwa siku ya vita, lakini Bwana ndiye aletaye wokovu. Hallelujah. We go to Ecclesiastes. Chapter 1. You finish Ecclesiastes, you are coming back up again. The words of the teacher, son of David, king in Jerusalem. Meaningless, meaningless, says the teacher. Utterly meaningless. Utterly meaningless. Everything is meaningless. What do people gain from all their labors at which they toil under the sun? Kama unafuata na Kiswahili, utafuata kwa Mhubiri kwanza. Generations come and generations go, but the earth remains forever. The sun rises and the sun sets and hurries back to where it rises. The wind blows to the south and turns to the north. Round and round it goes, ever returning on its course. All streams flow into the sea, yet the sea is never full. To the place the streams come from, there they will return again. All things are wearisome, more than one can say. The eye never has enough of seeing, nor the ear is filled of hearing. What has been will be again. What has been done will be done again. There is nothing new under the sun. Kumcha Bwana kumekuweko hata kutoka Abraham. Kumcha Bwana kulifanyika na kutafanyika tena. There is a time that God moved on the earth, and there is still a time that God is still moving on the earth. Let me tell you something, beloved. Kitabu hichi cha Mhubiri, Ecclesiastes 7, verse number 10. Those of you who say, tulikuwa tunaomba, tulikuwa tunafunga, we used to pray, we used to fast. Listen to what it says in Ecclesiastes 7, verse 10. It says, usiseme, kwani siku za kale kupita hizi. Usiseme, kwani siku za kale kupita hizi, siku hizi, maana si hekima uulizayo neno hili. It is not wise to say, better were the other days than this. God who did those things in season 1. God who did those things in season 2. God who did those things, he'll do them even in season 3. That as you read the word of God, something is going to change. You're not going to remain the same. You're not going to remain the same. Verse 9. There's nothing new under the sun. Is there anything of which one can say, look, this is something new? It was here already, long ago. It was here before our time. No one remembers the former generations. Even those yet to come will not be remembered. So don't take yourself too special. If you have been given a church to pastor, it has been pastored before. If you are given a worship team to lead, it has been led before. If you have been given a prayer meeting to lead, it has been led before. There is nothing new under the sun. No one can say, look, there's something new. It was here already, long ago. Before we read the scripture like this, Ezra was here before us. Reading out the scripture publicly. No one remembers the former generations. Not even those yet to come will not be remembered by those who follow them. Verse 12. I, the teacher, was king over Jerusalem. I applied my mind to study and to explore by wisdom all that is done under the heavens. What a heavy burden God has laid on mankind. I have seen all things that are done under the sun. All of them are meaningless. Are chasing after the wind. I love how it says it in Swahili. Just listen to the Swahili. Kukata upepo. Nasema aje verse 8. Mambo yote yamejaa uchofu. Usionekani. Usioneneneka. Jicho alishibu kwa. Wait. I am in verse. Verse 12. It says, mimi Mhubiri nalikuwa mfalme wa Israeli katika Yerusalemu. Nikatia moyo wangu ili kuyatafuta yote yanayotendeka chini ya mbingu na kuyavumbua kwa hekima ni taabu kubwa ambayo Mungu amewapa wanadamu ili kutaabika ndani yake. Nimeziona kazi zote zifanyazo chini ya jua na tazama mambo yote ni ubatili na kujilisha upepo. I like what it says. Kujilisha upepo. When you are riding a motorcycle or a convertible car, ndio utajua kujilisha upepo ni nini, because you'll be wind will be coming towards your face, chasing after the wind, kujilisha upepo. Verse 15, what is crooked cannot be straightened, what is lacking cannot be counted. I say to myself, look, I have increased in wisdom more than anyone ruled over Jerusalem before me. I have experienced much of wisdom and knowledge. Then I applied myself to the understanding of wisdom and also of madness and folly. But I learned that this too is a chasing after the wind. For with much wisdom comes much sorrow. And the more the knowledge, the more the grief. Katika wingi wa hekma, muna wingi wa huzuni. Naye aongezaye maarifa huongeza masikitiko. Hey! Tuanze tena. We are going to Ezekiel. Jaomba saa sita leo.
With God, we'll get the victory. With God, travel the enemy.
Yeah!
We'll get the victory.
Hizi ndio nyimbo za saa kama hizi.
With God, we'll get the victory. With God, scatter the enemy. With God, we'll gain the victory. With God will gain the victory.
Inasema, tukiwa na Mungu, tutashinda, ushindi mkubwa. Hallelujah. Kwa sababu farasi anatengenezwa kwa siku ya vita. Lakini ushindi. Sikia vile nasema, farasi uwekwa tayari kwa siku ya vita. Lakini Bwana ndiye aletaye wokovu. The horse is made ready for the day of battle, but the victory belongs to the Lord. Hey!
With God, we gain the victory. With God, scatter the enemies. With God, we'll gain the victory. With God, we'll gain the victory. We'll get the victory. With God, we'll gain the victory.
Seven.
The horse is made ready for the day of the battle. The victory belongs to the Lord. The crown and the shield and the beast and the bride. The victory belongs to the Lord. With God, we'll get the victory. With God, scatter the enemies. With God, we'll get the victory. With God, we'll gain the victory. With God,
hey,
we'll get the victory. With God,
nasema, ukiwa na Mungu, maadui wanatawanyika. Hallelujah.
With God, we'll gain the victory. House of Israel, trust in the Lord. The victory belongs to the Lord.
When it's nice, we play it twice, but we have to hold it because we gotta move on to Ezekiel chapter 7. The end has come. Hallelujah. Tumeingia katika kipindi kingine tena. Ezekiel 7. Bwana Yesu apewe sifa. Bwana Yesu apewe utukufu. Bwana Yesu ainuliwe. If you are watching this many, many days after it's broadcasted, this is everlasting. It can never be destroyed. It is work that God has allowed us to do. So as we ascend in the realm of the prayers and as we read the word of God, tunaposoma neno, tunajua mambo yale ambayo ni chukizo kwa Mungu. Na tunajua yale mambo yanampendeza. Kwa hivyo yale mambo yanampendeza ni mambo ya imani kama haya tunafanya. Kwa hivyo sikia. The word of the Lord came to me. Tena neno la Bwana likanijia kusema, Son of man, this is what the sovereign Lord says to the land of Israel. Na wewe mwanadamu, Bwana Mungu aiambia hivi nchi ya Israeli. The end has come. The end has come upon the four corners of the land. The end is now upon you, and I will unleash my anger against you. I will judge you according to your conduct and repay you all your detestable practices. I will not look on you with pity. I will not spare you. I will surely repay you for your conduct and for the detestable practices among you. Then you will know that I am the Lord. Hallelujah. Hadi mstari wa nne. Inasema, sasa mwisho huu unakupata, nami, wacha nianze verse 2. Na wewe mwanadamu, Bwana Mungu aiambia hivi nchi ya Israeli. Ni mwisho, mwisho umezijia pembe nne za nchi. Sasa mwisho huu unakupata, nami nitakuletea hasira yangu. Nitakuhukumu sawasawa na njia zako. Nami nitakupatiliza machukizo yako yote. Jicho langu halitakuachilia wala sitaona huruma, bali nitakupatiliza njia zako na machukizo yako yatakuwa katikati yako, nanyi mtajua ya kuwa mimi ndimi Bwana. This is what the sovereign Lord says, Ezekiel chapter 7 verse 5. This is what the sovereign Lord says. Disaster, unheard of disaster. See, it comes. The end has come. The end has come. It has roused itself against you. See, it comes. Bwana Mungu asema hivi. Ni jambo mbaya la namna ya pekee. Angalia linakuja. Mwisho umekuja. Mwisho umekuja. Huu umekuja. Unaamka ukapate, angalia unakuja. 7. Doom has come upon you. You will dwell in the land. The time has come. The day is near. There is panic, not joy, on the mountains. 7. Ajali yako imekujia, wewe ukaae katika nchi hii. Majira yamewadia, siku ile inakaribia, siku ya fujo. Wala si shangwe na, si ya shangwe milimani. 8. I am about to pour out my wrath on you and spend my anger against you. I will judge you according to your conduct and repay you for all your detestable practices. This is Ezekiel chapter 7 verse 8. Ezekieli 7 mstari wa 8. Basi hivi karibuni nitamwaga ghadhabu yangu juu yako. Nitazitimiza hasira zangu juu yako, nami nitakuhukumu sawasawa na njia zako, nami nitakupatiliza machukizo yako yote. Verse 9. I will not look on you with pity. I will not spare you. I will repay you for your conduct and for the detestable practices among you. Jicho langu halitaachilia wala sitaona huruma. Patiliza njia zako na machukizo yako yote yatakuwa katikati yako. Nanyi mtajua ya kuwa mimi Bwana napiga. Verse number 10. See the day. See it comes. Hallelujah. See the day. See it comes. Hallelujah. See the day. See it comes. Doom has burst forth and the rod has budded. Arrogance has blossomed. Violence has risen. A rod to punish the wicked. None of the people will be left. None of that crowd. None of their wealth. Nothing of value. Verse 12. The time has come. The day has arrived. Let not the buyer rejoice, nor the seller grieve. For my wrath is on the whole crowd. The seller will not recover the property that was sold, as long as both buyer and seller live. For the vision concerning the whole crowd will not be reversed because of their sins, Not one of them will preserve their life. They have blown the trumpet. They have made all things ready. Not one will go into battle. For my wrath is on the whole crowd. Outside is the sword. Inside are the plague and famine. Those in the country will die by the sword. Those in the city will be devoured by famine and plague. The fugitives who escape will flee to the mountains, like doves to the mountains, like doves of the valley. They will all mourn each of their own sins. Every hand will go limp. Every leg will be wet with urine. They will put on sackcloth and be clothed with terror. Every face will be covered with shame. Every head will be shaved. They will throw their silver into the streets, and their gold will be treated as a thing unclean. Their silver and gold will not be able to deliver them in the day of the Lord's wrath. It will not satisfy their hunger or fill their stomachs, for it has caused them to stumble into sin. Verse 20. They took pride in their beautiful jewelry and used it to make their detestable idols. They made it into vile images. Therefore, I will make it a thing unclean for them. I will give their wealth as plunder to foreigners and as loot of the wicked of the earth who will defile it. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Thank you for that testimony that has just come in. Glory to God. God is faithful. It says, I will give their wealth as plunder to foreigners and as loot to the wicked of the earth who will defile it. I will turn my face away from the people, and robbers will desecrate the place I treasure. They will enter it and will defile it. Where? Hapa kuna maneno. Prepare chains, for the land is full of bloodshed, and the city is full of violence. I will bring the most wicked of nations to take possession of their houses. I will put an end to the pride of the mighty, and their sanctuaries will be desecrated. When terror comes, they will seek peace in vain. Calamity upon calamity will come, and rumor upon rumor. They will go searching for a vision from the prophet. Priestly instruction in the law will cease, and the council of the elders will come to an end. The Lord will mourn, the prince will be clothed in despair, and the hands of the people of the land will tremble. I will deal with them according to their conduct. By their own standards, I will judge them. Then they will know that I am the Lord. Angalia siku hiyo. Angalia inakuja. Ajali yako imetokea. Fimbo imechanua, kiburi kimechipuka. Udhalimu umeinuka, ukawa fimbo ya uovu. Hapana mtu atakayesalia miongoni mwao, wala katika jamii yao, wala kitu katika utajiri wao, wala hakutakuwa kutukuka kati yao. Verse 12 of Ezekiel 7. Hallelujah. Majira yamewadia, siku ile inakaribia. Huyo anunuae asifurahi, wala asihuzunike auzae, maana ghadhabu imewapata wote jamii. Ha! Kwa maana auzae hata kirudia kilichouzwa, wajapokuwa wangali hai, kwa sababu maono haya yawahusu wote jamii. Hapana mmoja atakayerudi, wala hapana mtu atakayejiita mguvu katika uovu wa maisha yake. Wamepiga tarumbeta, wameweka vitu vyote tayari, lakini hapana aendaye vitani. Maana ghadhabu yangu imewapata wote jamii. Upanga uko nje na tauni na njaa zimo ndani. Yeye aliye nje mashambani atakufa kwa upanga. Ha, na yeye aliye ndani ya mji, njaa na tauni zitamla. Lakini watakapokimbia, watakimbia nao watakuwa juu ya milima kwa huwa wa bondeni, wote wakilia, kila mmoja katika uovu wake. Mikono yake itakuwa dhaifu, na magoti yote yatalegea kama maji. Tena watajifungia nguo za magunia, na utisho utawafunika, na aibu itakuwa juu ya nyuso yao, na upaa juu ya vichwa vyao wote. Watatupa fedha zao katika njia kuu ya mji, na dhahabu yao itakuwa kama kitu cha unajisi. Fedha yao na dhahabu yao hazitaweza kuokoa siku ya ghadhabu ya Bwana. Hawatajishibisha roho zao, wala hawatajijaza matumbo yao, kwa sababu zilikuwa kwazo la uovu wao. Verse 20. Na uzuri wa pambo lake yeye aliyoweka katika enzi, lakini wao walifanya sanamu na machukizo yao, na vitu vyao vichukizavyo ndani yake. Ndiyo maana nimeifanya kuwa kama kitu cha unajisi kwao. Verse 21. Nami nitapatia katika mikono ya wageni pawe mateka yao, na katika mikono ya waovu wa dunia pawe mawindo yao, na watapanajisi. Verse 22. Tena nitaugeuza uso wangu usiwaelekee, nao watapitia unajisi mahali pangu pasiri, na wanyang'anyi wataingia humo na kupatia unajisi. Verse 23. Ufue mnyororo, kwa maana nchi hii imejaa hukumu ya damu, nao mji umejaa udhalimu. Kwa sababu hiyo nitawaleta juu ya mataifa walio wabaya kabisa, nao watazimiliki nyumba zao, tena nitazikomesha kiburi chao wenye nguvu, na mahali pao patakatifu patatiwa unajisi. Verse 25. Uharibifu unakuja, nao watatafuta amani, lakini haitapatikana. Madhara yatakuja juu ya madhara, na habari ya shari juu ya habari ya shari, nao watakwenda kwa nabii katika maono, lakini hiyo sheria itampotea kuhani, na mashauri yatawapotea wazee. Mfalme ataomboleza, na mkuu atavikwa ukiwa, na mikono ya watu wa nchi itataabika. Nitawatenda masawa na njia zao, nami nitawahukumu sawa sawa na kustahili kwao, nao watajua ya kuwa mimi ndimi Bwana. Haleluya. Watajua mimi ndimi Bwana katika jina la Yesu. Watajua mimi ndimi Bwana katika jina la Yesu. Watajua mimi. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Asante Baba. Asante, asante, asante. Asante, asante Baba. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Wewe ni wa amani. Wewe ni Alpha. Wewe ni Yahwe. Wewe ni Mungu wetu. Wewe umetuwezesha kusoma haya maneno. Sawa. Sawa. Na ulivyo yaandika. Kwa hivyo tunakushukuru Baba. Tunasema wewe upewe sifa. Tunasema upewe utukufu. We go to the book. Tunaenda kitabu cha Revelation 7. Hallelujah. Revelation chapter 7, we are going to play the audio in Swahili, then we are going to read it in English. Hallelujah. Ufunuo wa Yohana, sura na mlango wa saba. Ndio unakuja sasa.
Mlango wa saba. Baada ya hayo, nikaona malaika wanne wamesimama katika pembe nne za nchi, wakizizuia pepo nne za nchi, upepo usivume juu ya nchi, wala juu ya bahari, wala juu ya mti wowote. Nikaona malaika mwingine akipanda kutoka mawio ya jua, mwenye muhuri ya Mungu aliye hai, akawapigia kelele kwa sauti kuu wale malaika wanne waliopewa kuidhuru nchi na bahari, akisema, msiidhuru nchi wala bahari wala miti hata tutakapokwisha kuwatia muhuri watumwa wa Mungu wetu juu ya vipaji vya nyuso zao. Nikasikia hesabu yao waliotiwa muhuri katika kila kabila ya Waisraeli, 144,000. Wa kabila ya Yuda, 12,000 waliotiwa muhuri. Wa kabila ya Rubeni, 12,000. Wa kabila ya Gadi, 12,000. Wa kabila ya Asheri, 12,000. Wa kabila ya Naftali, 12,000. Wa kabila ya Manase, 12,000. Wa kabila ya Simeoni, 12,000. Wa kabila ya Lawi, 12,000. Wa kabila ya Isakari, 12,000. Wa kabila ya Zabuloni, 12,000. Wa kabila ya Yusufu, 12,000. Wa kabila ya Benyamini, 12,000 waliotiwa muhuri. Baada ya hayo nikaona, natazama, mkutano mkubwa sana, ambao hapana mtu awezaye kuhesabu. Watu wa kila taifa, na kabila, na jamaa, na lugha, wamesimama mbele ya kile kiti cha enzi, na mbele za mwanakondoo. Wamevikwa mavazi meupe, wana matawi ya mitende mikononi mwao, wakilia kwa sauti kuu wakisema, wokovu una Mungu wetu akitii katika kiti cha enzi na mwana kondoo. Na malaika wote walikuwa wakisimama pande zote za kile kiti cha enzi, na za hao wazee, na za wale wenye uhai wanne, na wakaanguka kifulifuli mbele ya kile kiti cha enzi, wakamsujudu Mungu wakisema, amina, baraka na utukufu na hekima na shukrani na heshima na uweza na nguvu zina Mungu wetu hata milele na milele, amina. Akajibu mmoja wa wale wazee akiniambia, je, watu hao waliovikwa mavazi meupe ni kina nani na wametoka wapi? Nikamwambia, mwana wangu, wajua wewe. Akaniambia, hao ndio wanatoka katika dhiki ile iliyokuu, na wamefua mavazi yao na kuyafanya meupe katika damu ya mwana kondoo. Kwa hiyo wako mbele ya kiti cha enzi cha Mungu, na wanamtumikia mchana na usiku katika hekalu lake, na yeye aketii katika kiti cha enzi atatanda hema yake juu yao. Hawataona njaa tena, wala hawataona kiu tena, wala jua halitawapiga, wala hari yoyote, kwa maana huyo mwana kondoo aliye katikati ya kiti cha enzi
atawachunga,
naye atawaongoza kwenye chemchemi za maji yenye uhai, na Mungu atayafuta machozi yote katika macho yao.
Hallelujah. Welcome the day to charity. We have just read in Swahili Revelation 7. Tutasoma na kizungu sasa. Revelation 7. Hallelujah. The sixth pack. After this I saw four angels standing at the four corners of the earth, holding back the four winds of the earth to prevent any wind from blowing on the land or on the sea or any tree. Then I saw another angel coming from the east, having the seal of the living God. He called out in a loud voice to the four angels who had been given power to harm the land and the sea. Do not harm the land or the sea or the trees until we put a seal on the foreheads of the servants of God. Then I heard the number of those who are sealed. 144,000 from all the tribes of Israel. From the tribe of Judah, 12,000 were sealed. From the tribe of Reuben, 12,000. From the tribe of Gad, 12,000. From the tribe of Asher, 12,000. From the tribe of Naphtali, 12,000. From the tribe of Manasseh, 12,000. From the tribe of Gad, Simeon, 12,000. From the tribe of Levi, 12,000. From the tribe of Issachar, 12,000. From the tribe of Joseph, 12,000. From the tribe of Benjamin, 12,000. After this I looked, and there before me was a great multitude that no one could count, from every nation, tribe, people, language, standing before the throne and before the Lamb. They were wearing white robes and were holding palm branches in their hands, and they cried out in a loud voice, "Salvation belongs to our God, who sits on the throne, and to the Lamb." All the angels were standing around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures. They fell down on their faces before the throne and worshiped God, saying, "Amen. Praise and glory and wisdom and thanks and honor and power and strength be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders asked me, "These in white robes, who are they? And where did they come from?" I answered, "Sir, you know." And he said, "These are they who have come out of the great tribulation. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. Therefore, they are before the throne of God and serve him day and night in his temple. And he who sits on the throne will shelter them with his presence." Aye, listen. "From the plague, from the plague, from the famine, and from the sword. The one who sits on the throne will shelter them with his presence. Never again will they hunger. Never again will they thirst. The sun will not beat down on them, nor any scorching heat. For the Lamb at the center of the throne will be their shepherd, and he will lead them to springs of living water. And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes." In Isaiah 25, verse 8, this same scripture is making some sense there. So, Isaiah 25 verse 8 says, "He will swallow up death forever. The sovereign Lord will wipe away the tears from all faces. He will remove his people's disgrace from all the earth. The Lord has spoken." Hallelujah. We go to the book of Titus, the last book of Titus. Then tomorrow we'll look at Philemon as we continue to go over these books again and again and again and again and again and again. We've already gone through James twice, and now we're on the second time of Revelation. What a job. Titus 3. These are small books, but they're very powerful. Tito wa tatu. Alafu tuingie kwa maombi ya saa 6. alafu tumalize mkutano. Tito. I will read in Swahili then in English. No, I'll read verse by verse. That will go faster. Remind the people to be subject to rulers and authority, to be obedient, and to be ready to do whatever is good. Wakumbushe watu kunyenyekea kwa wenye uwezo na mamlaka na kutii na kuwa tayari kwa kila kazi njema. To slander no one, to be peaceable and considerate, and always to be gentle towards everyone. Wasimtukane mtu yeyote, wasiwe wagomvi, wawe wema, wakionyesha upole wote kwa watu wote. Verse 3. At one time, we too were foolish, disobedient, deceived, and enslaved by all kinds of passions and pleasures. Maana hapo zamani sisi nasi tulikuwa hatuna akili, tulikuwa waasi, tumedanganywa, huku tukitumikia tamaa na anasa za namna nyingi, tukiishi katika uovu na usuda, tukichukiza na tukichukiana. Verse 4. But when the kindness and the love of God our Father appeared, lakini wema wake mukozi wetu Mungu na upendo wake kwa wanadamu ulipofunuliwa, alituokoa. Amen. Verse 5. He saved us not because of righteous things we had done, but because of his mercy, he saved us through the washing of rebirth and renewal by the Holy Spirit. Si kwa sababu ya matendo ya haki tuliyoyatenda sisi, bali kwa rehema yake, kwa kuoshwa, kwa kuzaliwa kwa pili, na kufanywa upya na Roho Mtakatifu. Verse 6. Whom he poured out on us generously through Jesus Christ our Savior, ambaye alitumwagia kwa wingi kwa njia ya Yesu Kristo mwokozi wetu. Verse 7. So that having been justified by this grace, we might become heirs, having the hope of eternal life. Verse 7. Ili tukihesabiwe haki kwa neema yake, tupate kufanywa warithi wa uzima wa milele, kama lilivyo tumaini letu. Verse 8. This is a trustworthy saying, and I want you to stress these things so that those who have trusted in God may be careful to devote themselves to doing what is good. These things are excellent and profitable for everyone. Mstari wa 8. Ni neno la kuaminiwa, na mambo hayo nataka uyanene kwa nguvu, ili wale waliomwamini Mungu wakumbuke kudumu katika matendo mema. Hayo ni mazuri, tena yana faida kwa wanadamu. Verse 9. But avoid foolish controversies and genealogies and arguments and quarrels about the law, because they are unprofitable and useless. Hallelujah. Lakini maswali ya upuzi ujiepushe nayo, na nasaba na magomvi na mashindano ya sheria, kwa kuwa hayana faida, tena hayana maana. Verse 10. Warn a divisive person once, and when then warn them a second time. After that, have nothing to do with them. Mtu aliye mzushi, baada ya kumuonya mara ya kwanza na mara ya pili, mkatai. Verse 11. You may be sure that such people are warped and sinful. They are self-condemned. Verse number 11. Ukijua ya kuwa mtu kama huyo amepotoka, tena atenda dhambi, maana amejihukumu katika yeye mwenyewe. Verse 12. As soon as I send Artemas or Tychicus to you, do your best to come to me at Nicopolis, because I have decided to winter there. Wakati nitakapomtuma Artema kwako au Tikitiko, jitahidi kuja kwangu uko Nikopoli, kwa maana huko nimekusudia kukaa wakati wa baridi. Verse 14. Our people must learn to devote themselves to doing what is good in order to provide for urgent needs and not live unproductive lives. Verse 14. Watu wetu nao wajifunze kudumu katika matendo mema kwa matumizi yaliyo lazima, ili wasiwe hawana matunda. Verse 15. Everyone with me sends you greetings. Those who love us in the faith, grace be with you all. Verse 15. Watu wote walio pamoja nami wakusalimu. Tusalimu. Hallelujah. Tusalimie wale watupendao katika imani. Neema na iwe pamoja nanyi nyote. Hallelujah. Neema nawe iwe pamoja nanyi wote. The grace of the Lord be upon you all. As we come to pray at the Kenyan midday hour, napokuja kuomba katika wakati huu wa maombi wa saa sita, tunataka tumwambie Mungu, want to tell God, be our shield, kuwa ngao yetu, kuwa ngao yetu, be our shield. Mambo ambayo ametukubalisha tuweze kuyajua. The things that God has allowed us to know, my sister Jeanette. The things that he has allowed you to come into contact with in his word, allowing you to help others escape hell. Father, we love you at this gate of time as you ascend. We pray at this ascension of this time, my Father, that kwamba Mungu takuwa nasi, that God you'll be with us. That Father, you'll shine your light upon the brethren. Give us a divine shield. Lord, in this time that we are seeing pestilence, we are seeing plagues, we are seeing famine, we are seeing sword. Father, we pray at this gate of time in the name of Jesus that he who dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. That I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. Surely he will save you from the fowler's snare and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with his feathers, and under his wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness will be your shield and rampart. You will not fear the terror of night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor the pestilence that stalks in the darkness, nor the plague that wastes at noonday. 1,000 may fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come near you. It will not come near me. It shall only observe the eyes and see the punishment of the wicked. If you make the Most High your dwelling, even the Lord who is my refuge, then no harm will befall you, no disaster will come near your tent. For he will command his angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. They will lift you up in their hands so that You will not strike your foot against a stone. You will tread upon the lion and the cobra. You will trample the great lion and the serpent. Because he loves me, says the Lord, I will rescue him. I will protect him, for he acknowledges my name. He will call upon me, and I will answer him. He will be with me in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life will I satisfy him and show him my salvation. Hallelujah. Zaburi 91. Bwana Yesu asifiwe katika hii nafasi ya time. Hallelujah. Tukiambia Mungu, wewe Baba, wewe ndio ngao yetu ya kimungu. Wewe ndio our divine shield. Wewe ndio ngao yetu ya kimungu. Atakaye mahali, aketie mahali pa siri. Paki aliye juu, atakaa katika uvuli wake Mwenyezi. Nitasema Bwana ndiye kimbilio langu na ngome langu, Mungu wangu nitakaye mtumaini. Naana yeye atakuokoa na mtego wa mwindaji, na katika tauni uharibio. Hey, kwa manyoya yake atakufunika, chini ya mbawa zake utapata kimbilio. Uaminifu wake ni ngao na kigao. Utaogopa ofu ya usiku, wala mshale urukao mchana, wala tauni ipitayo gizani, wala uwele uharibio adhuhuri. Baba, uwele uharibio adhuhuri siku ya leo. Tunaomba ya kwamba hatutaweza kukaribiwa na uwele katika jina la Yesu. Ijapo watu 1,000 waanguke ubavuni pako, na 10,000 mkononi mwako, yes, wakuume, hata hivyo hatutakaribia wewe, ila kwa macho yako utatazama na kuyaona malipo ya wasio haki. Kwa kuwa wewe Bwana ndio kimbilio langu, umemfanya aliye juu kuwa makao yako. Mbaya hayatakupata wewe, mabaya hayatakupata wewe, wala tauni haitakaribia hema yako. Kwa kuwa atakuagizia malaika zake wakulinde katika njia zako zote. Mikononi mwao watakuchukua, usije ukajikwaa mguu wako katika jiwe. Usije ukakwaa mguu wako katika jiwe. Utawakanyaga simba na nyoka. Mwana simba na joka utawaseta kwa miguu. Kwa kuwa amekaza kunipenda, nitamuokoa na kumweka palipo juu. Kwa kuwa amenijua jina langu, ataniita nami nitamuitika. Nitakuwa pamoja naye taabuni, nitamuokoa na kumtukuza. Kwa siku nyingi nitamshibisha, nami nitamuonyesha wokovu wangu. That is Psalm 91 in Swahili. Tunashukuru Mungu, hakuna kama yeye. We thank God for this far that he has brought us. Day 84. He's a great God. Father, we thank you for this far you brought us. Lord, be exalted. I pray, Lord God, even at this time when with all this pandemic and everything that is happening, Father, may you keep us safe, Lord. Utuweke mbali na tauni ya ribuyo. My Father, keep us safe, Lord. Keep us safe. Keep your children safe. And those that are sick, Lord, deliver them. Deliver them. Father, we thank you, Lord, because you are a faithful God. We thank you because we know that you are with us. Lord, now I commit this entire journey and everyone involved in this journey into your hands. Lord, even them that are watching this randomly, even them that are coming across these videos later, minister to them in your own way. For Father, this is your word. This is your word, Lord. Perfect it. Pursue it. Bring your word to the people. Bring your favor to the people. Father, thank you for your grace. Thank you for your goodness. Thank you for enabling us to pray at this gate of time. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Yeah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. So, subscribe on the YouTube channel if you have not done so. And we are continuing with the journey. Mission Monday is coming up. Mission Monday is coming up to Magadi. And we bless the Lord for His goodness and His mercy. Shalom. For those of you who would like to give your life to Christ, while you are not going to talk, the word of the Lord says in Romans chapter 10, verse 9, ukikiri kwa kinywa chako Yesu ni Bwana na waamini kwa moyo wako ya kwamba Mungu alimfufua kutoka kwa wafu, utaokoka. Hallelujah. Utaokoka. You shall be saved. That's right. Shalom. God bless you all. I love you for the love of the Lord. Asante. Nawapenda bure katika jina la Yesu.